Welcome back, gamers. I've raised enough funds to buy myself a table, meaning it's time to announce a contest on it. I thought about things I could potentially give away, but well, you know. But I don't want to leave my loyal fans out in the cold. So I've designed some official IRAT gamer posters. Yes, these prestigious wall improvers could be yours. All you have to do is write the words, "Pick me, I'm willing to look like a mindless sheep for a prize not worth the time it took to comment." Boost my comment rating, I mean, pander as many times as you'd like. And don't forget to subscribe because, well, I'm not gonna get subscribers any other way. Anyway, keep giving me YouTube money and as always, game. What the fuck is this? Dear IRAT Gamer, I've been battling with explosive diarrhea for the past year of my life. However, no matter how much Taco Bell I don't eat, the diarrhea just won't go into remission. I'm at the point where I have a week or two to live, according to the doctors. My one regret is that my favorite game never got reviewed by someone worth a damn. Shit. I guess I should review this, so that I'll look like an upstanding citizen. Alright, let's get to it.
Special effects.
Well, hey gamers. As you know, the IRAT Gamer fanbase is full of all sorts of different kinds of people. Some of these people happen to have life-threatening disabilities that threaten their very lives. For example, I recently received a heart-wrenching tale from one of my loyal fans. He or she has an explosive diarrhea and could really use my reviewing powers to cure it. Right, we remote? Fine. Leave me. Just like everybody else. Anyway, that's why today, we're going to take a look at an obscure game at the fans' request. Halo 5 for the Xbox One. Let's stick this game in the Nintendo Wii and get started.
The wind that sweeps the sky clean and lets the sun shine again. This is the most magnificent.
I hope your terminal illness gets better soon, Yamaha.
Here is heaven and earth and the brilliant sky in between. Blessed is this life and I'm gonna celebrate.
Looking at the box, you can see the game seems quite promising. You play as the severed torso of a marine in front of an active Ark of the Covenant. Nice. So imagine my disappointment when I download the footage and the marine torso is nowhere to be found. Why am I just floating through this alien spaceship? Where's Indigo Jones and the Ark? The game keeps mentioning the Covenant, but I can't find their goddamn Ark. The game has 4 difficulties, but there's clearly only one suitable for me. The game starts out with a long-winded introduction. Come to think of it, this game is full of cutscenes. What is this? An FMV game? Who cares about the story? Skip the shit. Your main enemy is the giant popcorn potato, and you'll be finding them in all sorts of different shapes and sizes. Like small, big, and Bob Uecker. Huh. Your objective is to stop the popcorn creatures before they infect and mutate all alienkind into disfigured repulsive monsters like them. Just watching this game is making me hungry. I was saving this for emergencies, but oh well. Anyway, you'd think the game developers would be able to come up with better villains than that.
What did you say about our kind?
You heard me? Your pansy-ass developers should have come up with better villains.
Why, you son of a bitch? And don't do it again, ha ha ha.
And just look at the dumbass you're playing as. When you finally escape the enemies and board your ship, you accidentally bring some stupid humans with you. Then your friends start shooting you thinking you're one of them. Talk about a hero's welcome. The rest of the game is spent trying to stay alive because everyone's out to kill you. All because you play as a fucking retard. Who thought this was a good idea? Microsoft? Of course. The same douchebags that made Magic School Bus. And we all know how shitty that game was. What's really stupid is that some places you can only get to by throwing a grenade, a move ripped right out of Super Metroid for the GameCube. But unlike in Super Metroid, it takes almost all of your health. If there are enemies around the corner, you're fucked. This game is glitchier than YouTube's player design. I clearly stunned his ass, he's electrified to shit, and he's still running around like he's got a propeller up his ass. Wow, this game is making me hungry again. It's almost as if that electrified animation doesn't mean he's stunned or something. The best part of the game is when you find the Queen Popcorn Monster and this marine punches through her skull. Friggin' sweet. This game can be pretty scary. I still feel the rush of adrenaline while tiptoeing down the long corridors, not knowing when things would pop out at me. Whoa. Damn it, Michael. I'm not sure why I'm getting so angry over things that I obviously photoshopped into the game. Or why I ostensibly think it's so funny. You might be thinking this would be a good time to talk about the gameplay, or at least the graphics and sound. But fuck that, my job is to make vaguely angry gargling sounds and monkey faces at the camera. I don't want to spoil the ending for anyone, but the ending of the game sucks. It turns into a cheap Monster Truck Rally ripoff. Yet another shitty game by Microsoft. Then as you board a ship while the planet explodes underneath you, your marine friend closes the door before anyone else can get on. What a douchebag, I'm glad I wasn't playing as him. What a shitload of fuck. So that's Halo 5. I hope you enjoyed this review of your favorite game, Yamaha.
Surprise, motherfucker.
What the fuck are you doing?
I'm here to bring the funnies to your review by attacking, and or mildly inconveniencing you.
What part of that is in any way funny?
Well, it gives you the opportunity to make more monkey faces at the camera, and to swear. Swearing is funny.
How is any of that funny to anyone that isn't, like, 9 years old?
Well, maybe we can engage in an epic battle instead, with more special effects than a Michael Bay movie. All the cool internet reviewers are doing it.
Why would we do that? In an internet review, there's no dramatic tension to be emotionally invested in it, and no one's special effects are good enough for it to be just fun to watch. Wouldn't it just be superfluous, and out of place in a mere internet review?
But internet reviews need story arcs. Story arcs that involve the survival of mankind, or at least threaten the life of the reviewer, and are the reviewer's friends.
Why?
Because it's cool.
No, it's not. It's not cool at all. It's a stupid fad among egotistical reviewers who think way too highly of their pretentious reviews,